So asked a counter question which I did not expect at all. So since I had conflated UPSC and RBI together in one answer, so the chairman asked me that if you are given a job of Home Secretary and of a job as RBI governor, then which one will you choose? So this one was a real googly. So
Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today I have Tuhin with me who has cleared RBI Grade B examination for the year 2021. First of all, congratulations Tuhin on setting this feat, on clearing this difficult, tough examination that lakhs of students probably aspire to crack one day or the other.
Thanks Anuj. So it's been quite a challenge and quite some time, but I'm really glad that's happened finally.
Perfect. So, sabse pehle, first of all, I would want you to introduce yourself, tell the aspirants a little bit about yourself, jisse unko pata lage ki bhai ye jo success hai, iske piche kya kya challenges rahe hain, kya kya failures rahe hain. That is very important, I feel.
Yeah, definitely. So, I graduated in 2015 in mechanical engineering from IIT Kharagpur. And after that, I started working in a consultancy firm, VS Associates. I worked there for 1 year and after that, I felt that I needed something more in my life. I needed some more impact. So I quit my job and started preparing for UPSC in 2016. I gave the civil services exam in 17, 18, 19, and 20. So I reached up to the main stage. And along with that, I was also giving the RBI exam. I gave it in 18, 19, and 21 right now. And also the UP State PCS exam. So in UPSC, I had quite a lot of string of failures. It happens quite a while. And I was unsuccessful even in prelims quite a few times. I was unsuccessful in mains. And even in the RBI exam, this is the first time that I reached the interview stage and I was successful. I did manage to get some success in the PCS exam. I reached the interview stage, but even then I was unable to clear the final list. So I must, I want to take this opportunity to tell all aspirants that it's always a difficult process. I mean, for any of these exams that you see, so many lakhs of candidates are giving the exam, in order to get selected, you have to be in a fraction of 1%. So it's always going to be difficult no matter how hard you prepare. But what you can do from your side is to prepare the entire syllabus, prepare everything, and then just keep trying. It's more of a statistical game after that.
तो यस आई थिंक यू पुट इट वेरी राइटली कि बहुत स्टेटिस्टिकल गेम हो जाता है एंड योर रिलेटिव परफॉर्मेंस मैटर्स अ लॉट मोर देन योर एब्सोल्यूट परफॉर्मेंस एट अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स सो योर ऑब्जेक्टिव योर जॉब इज टू जस्ट कंप्लीट द सिलेबस अपना 100% देना है एंड देन आई थिंक यू शुड जस्ट लीव इट टू गॉड वेरी वेल सेड तो आई वुड अगेन वॉन्ट टू रिपीट द सेम थिंग दैट यू सेड कि जो सक्सेस आपको दिख रहा है एज एन एस्पिरेंट There is a lot of failure at times attached to it. Or jo log students who are able to consistently perform, who are able to persist those hardships, a lot of students among those are able to shine. Like today, Suheen, we have an example. 5 saal, 6 saal ho chuke hain. He's been struggling for such a long time, and now he's finally seen success. So, ye persistence or consistency wali jo baat hai, that becomes very important. Okay, perfect. Let's switch to the preparation strategy. Of course, you are a UPSC aspirant, so it is very obvious ki aapki kahin na kahin there have been overlaps and your UPSC prep must have helped. But let us start from the very beginning. Phase 1 ke liye, did you prepare separately? If yes, what and how? And then we'll move to phase 2.
Yeah. So there is some overlap between UPSC preparation and RBI preparation, but I think RBI preparations requires its own dedicated inputs. Because actually this happened to me in the 2019 RBI exam, that I didn't have a lot of time to prepare for the phase one, and I was unable to clear the phase one itself, even though I cleared it in 2018. So I think the kind of current affairs asked in the phase one exam of RBI is a bit different from what is asked in UPSC, especially this year. That some of the questions were very detailed and very minute questions. And also, I think for some people, maybe particularly with a non-engineering background, they might need to practice a bit more on the quantitative questions and the aptitude parts of the paper, maybe even English. So in that respect, I think only practice can help you. And when it comes to current affairs, for UPSC, I used to follow many of the typical current affairs sources from Vision IAS and other coaching material. That I think forms a solid base of knowledge, mm-hmm. with which you can maybe even guess a few questions, or with which you can answer some questions of which you don't really know the answer to directly. Mm-hmm. But other than that, I think you need some pinpointed preparation for RBI phase one. And for that, I think this magazines like Spotlight mm-hmm. and some other banking related materials are also very useful. Mm-hmm. I think they are not very lengthy, and for RBI at least you don't need to prepare 2 years and even 3 years of current affairs like you need to do for UPSC. Mm-hmm. So focus. And another thing that that was very peculiar in RBI as compared to UPSC, that the latest current affairs are more important here mm-hmm. as compared to UPSC. So just 1 month before the exam and 2 months before the exams, you need to go in a reverse order actually of preparing for your current affairs, and you need to memorize some very minute details as well.
Perfect. I think बहुत अच्छी बात बोली है कि reverse order में चलना है. This is one thing that I also keep repeating. बहुत सारे students को समझ आ जाता है. A lot of students are unable to understand how do we pull it off. कि भाई पहले September कैसे करें before doing August. How do we actually understand September's current affairs before actually covering August. But it is possible once you start doing it. One more question that I have for you with respect to phase one is, you talked about quant reasoning in English very briefly, and you talked about practicing. So I remember I have been talking over the past 3-4 days with some students jo ki bol rahe hain sir practice kar rahe hain, but even then we are not able to improve. Now there is a very people who practice are able to realize ki bhai how does it work. So if you have that experience and if you are able to recall ki bhai tumne jab practice kiya tha, how did it go about, were you able to immediately improve your performance, or how did it happen? If you can share some thoughts about that.
Yes, definitely. So the first time that I tried to take a mock test, I found that even though I did not have a lot of difficulty in solving many of the questions, but I took a lot of time, and it was frankly, it seemed impossible to me that I would be able to complete, even reach the last question, let alone solve it in the limited amount of time that RBI has, and especially now with the sectional timers and everything. So the most important thing that I found was prioritization, especially in quant and in reasoning. There are very limited types of questions. You can easily identify this type of question, this is the second type of question, this is the third type of question, and this is the approach to follow in order to solve that question. See some solved examples of that, what is the correct approach, and you need to develop some shortcuts that every time I see this question, this is the way I'll go. I don't have to think about it. You have to memorize your complete method, and you also have to see the type of questions that you are not able to solve. For example, क्वांट में जो इस तरह का क्वेश्चन आता है दैट यू हैव टू फिल इन द सीरीज की इसमें इसके बाद क्या आएगा, वो मुझसे नहीं हो पाता है. आई नो दैट कि आई एम नॉट एबल टू डू इट. सो एज सून एज आई सी दैट क्वेश्चन आई एम गोइंग टू लीव इट. आई डोंट हैव टू वेस्ट एनी टाइम ऑन दैट. एंड देयर आर सम अदर क्वेश्चंस एज वेल व्हिच आई फाउंड दैट आई एम जस्ट नॉट एबल टू डू. सो क्रिएट अ प्रायोरिटी लिस्ट एंड देन यू विल हैव सम बेसिक फ्यू क्वेश्चंस दैट यू विल बी एबल टू सॉल्व इन दैट लिमिटेड अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम, दैट विल बी एनफ. बिकॉज in the end, basically GA is the deciding factor, I feel. So if you are able to do a decent job in aptitude with these methods, I think that will do.
Perfect. I think काफी अच्छे से आपने बता दिया है कि what exactly happens when you prepare phase one. Now jumping on to phase two, although I know that UPSC aspirant ho, again coming back to the same point, descriptive mein fayda mila hoga. But I know as a fact ki bahut sare jo fayde hum sochte hain, the things that we assume that okay, he's a UPSC aspirant, he must have had this advantage, those were true only to some extent and not completely, because the pattern was a little different, the length of the answers was different. So did you have any specific strategy, and did you prepare separately for it? How did you go about it?
Yeah, so आई थिंक इट्स अ बिट ऑफ अ मिथ कि यूपीएससी के एस्पिरेंट्स को इस बार फायदा हुआ होगा. आई मीन अगर इफ यू डोंट हैव एनी आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस एट ऑल, व्हिच आई थिंक इज अ वेरी बैड थिंग टू डू फॉर एनी इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एनी एग्जाम एट ऑल, सो देन मे बी यू हैव अ डिसएडवांटेज आई थिंक. बट यूपीएससी का जो आंसर राइटिंग होता है एंड दिस आंसर राइटिंग व्हिच वी हैड हियर वाज different in two aspects mostly. First, the word limit, as you said, the word limit was quite high here. And the second that in UPSC, except for the optional subjects, the questions asked are very general in nature. You have to elaborate more, you have to think more, you have to brainstorm and think about points. Whereas in RBI, the questions are very technical in nature. They're very factual. So what mattered more was not the answer writing practice, I think. In fact, I don't think I spent a lot of time practicing writing answers. I spent most of my time learning about the theories and concepts, because that's what was important. For example, if I recall, one question was about the pillars of Basel III. So I don't think any answer writing practice would help you at all if you don't know about Basel III. And if you know everything, all the pillars about Basel 1, 2, 3 and all the background information, then you won't have any problems writing a structured answer on that. So it's more about knowledge and preparation rather than about answer writing practice when it comes to RBI.
Right. Because the questions are more academic in nature rather than current affairs oriented. Probably that is the reason. How about English descriptive? Because is wale success se pehle, you have had your failures both in RBI as well as UPSC. So, kahin na kahin, I'm very certain English descriptive mein kam zyada number rahe honge. You must have had some variations. So, how did you ensure? Did you work upon it and did you ensure ki this time the variations should not happen?
Yeah. So the last time that I gave RBI phase 2 in 2018, I did not make it to the interview mostly because of my marks in English. I scored well in the other two sections, but English marks काफी कम थे. And the diagnosis that I had for that was in the essay writing part. I had not practiced specifically for writing an essay for RBI. I was thinking कि अरे मैंने तो UPSC दे रखा है, मुझे तो essay writing कोई problem ही नहीं होनी चाहिए. And I went there and I was struggling to compile an essay within 300 words itself. So on the spot, I had to change the pattern of my essay. I had to change my complete paradigm within the limited amount of time. So I would advise people for the essay part that an essay needs to have certain elements. It's not a 300 word answer, first of all, that you can write in points, you can write the facts. Essay needs to have an introduction, a body and a conclusion, and it needs to have a proper language, proper elaborative language. That's important. And in the body, of course, you will need to include points in a structured manner. And also not what I mean by structured manner is that you don't have to throw the points that point one, point two, point three, and I've given so many points, why didn't I get marks? It's not like that. You have to create a flow. A whole essay should read like a single unit. So you have to practice for that. And don't think a lot about including a lot of facts or data. That shouldn't be the focus, to put in as many facts and as many points as possible. Rather, it should be a more coherent argument. So that was, I think, one of the mistakes that I was earlier making as well. Because I was trying to write a 300 word answer rather than an essay.
Perfect. So how did you improve upon it this time? That is the real question.
Yeah, actually, I did see quite a few videos about that. How to write an essay. I also practiced along with many of the essay writing exercises going on for you for RBI specifically. So I got in touch with a few aspirants as well who had earlier given the interview as well for RBI, and I asked them to rate my essay, how I was writing, whether it had all the elements or not. And I wrote several essays, and after some time I used to revisit my essays from before and just check whether it had all the elements or not, whether it had a proper, because when you read an essay after a long period of time, then it strikes you that this doesn't really make sense as a whole. When I was writing, then it felt that it was in a flow, but it's not. I think practice is the key.
Perfect. I think you've put it very nicely. Now that the exam is descriptive, abhi thoda sa UPSC orientation, they've also included that by making it descriptive. Honestly, how much time do you think is enough for a student who is not an aspirant of UPSC to write and clear the examination or to have a very decent attempt to be confident when he's going in for the examination ki yaar mera ho sakta hai, maine acche se taiyari ki hai. How much time do you think is required now because the examination is a lot different?
Time is something that actually varies from person to person. Actually, many people have very different aptitudes. But for a comfortable attempt, I would say one which is not in a hurried manner and which you can prepare in a comfortable manner, I think starting 6 to 7 months before phase one would be quite comfortable. Because for phase one, I think the current affairs that you have to complete, you can complete it in 2 months or slightly more than 2 months. You don't need more than that. And if you also need to cover the factual syllabus for ESI and FNM, that will also take at least 1.5 months each. And along with the answer writing practice and English practice, I think 6 to 7 months would be quite comfortable. And you should definitely look for completing the phase two preparation, at least 90% of the phase two preparation before phase one itself. There's very little time.
That was going to be my next question. Did you start with your phase one prep or your phase two prep? Because last year, a lot of students made this mistake despite us telling them again and again. And the current affairs of phase one exam had a lot of phase two type questions. So how did you go about it?
Yeah, so I definitely knew beforehand itself that you have to start phase two preparation before phase one. Because this is one of the troubles I actually faced in my first attempt in 2018. Frankly, this year, fortunately, we had a lot of time on our hands because the exam was getting delayed and no one knew when the notification would come. So some people whiled away that time, but you had to utilize that time when which was given, a lot of time that was given. So I started my phase two preparation, I think, in December or later November. And I started with the current affairs in ESI and the static portion of ESI and even the static portion of FNM. Even though I knew that static portion of FNM, at least, mostly management at least, would definitely not be asked in the phase one exam. But I completed my notes on it. I did not try to memorize it or anything. And when it comes to ESI and the finance portion, whenever I read any current affairs on that, I always felt that this is something that can be asked in phase one. And if they ask in phase one, then no one can say that this is wrong. So even though I did not practice any answer writing on that, but I kept a tab on it. I kept revising those current affairs as well, because as I said before, that there are many portions of knowledge, especially the current affairs of UPSC, static portion of UPSC, that even though it's not directly part of the syllabus, but if you know these things, and if you come across a question that you do not know the answer to, then these are the things that, these are the background knowledge that help you guess the answers. So current affairs of ESI and finance are definitely important even for phase one itself. And RBI showed us that, yeah, you had to do that.
Perfect. You have a gap. You have a long gap. You passed out in 2015, left your job in 2016. So almost 5 saal ka gap hai. You must have had to face some challenge in the interview round. Did you face any challenges when it came to filling this gap, and how did you deal with this?
Yeah. So I think the first question that the chairman sir asked me was, what are you doing right now? So I think from this question, he meant to infer exactly about my gap itself. So I had already anticipated this question. It's very important to prepare your answer beforehand. So my answer was going to be along the lines of my career goals. That these are the career goals that I have in mind. And these, so for that, and these are the opportunities that I'm looking for. I'm looking for UPSC, I'm looking for State PCS, I'm looking for RBI. So that's what I told him, that currently I'm not working anywhere, but these are my career goals and I'm determined to achieve these aspects, these goals in my career wherever I go. So that's why I'm going to keep trying, and whether it be at RBI or whether it be at State PCS. And it's not that I am taking a huge risk with my career or I'm reckless or anything. So I have made some plan B's, plan C's and plan D's. For example, I also gave the CAT exam and I'm also trying for an MBA. I'm also trying for a job. So with the given amount of time that a lot of time has passed, I'm also looking for backup and exit options. But since these are my career goals and it is my determination to work in the public sector, so I've not given up hope and I'm still trying for all of these jobs. So I think it was a decent attempt at an answer given the long gap. I think any candidates with a gap should focus more on their career goals and why they have done this, why they have such a long career gap, rather than being apologetic about it.
Right, of course, of course. You have to be confident and you have to accept that this is something that you've decided. Right. So did they ask you any counter question based upon your answer?
Yeah. So based upon my answer, they asked a counter question which I did not expect at all. So since I had conflated UPSC and RBI together in one answer, so the chairman asked me that if you are given a job of Home Secretary and of a job as RBI Governor, then which one will you choose? So this was... this one was a real googly. So what I told him was that both of these jobs are very high and in responsibility and position and at the very same level of decision making and importance in nation building. So the comparison is quite difficult, but in these two jobs I think I would go for an RBI governor, and the reason would be that it is a very specialized job as compared to Home Secretary. And it's not that if I had gone for the route of, it's not that I'm saying that I would have preferred to go for an for the RBI exam rather than UPSC. UPSC was my first preference. But even in UPSC, it does not mean that you have to become a generalist. You can specialize. For example, the current RBI governor is also an IAS. So he has specialized and acquired a lot of knowledge in the financial sector. And that is why he is the RBI governor. So for the specialization and knowledge point of view, I would go for an RBI governor. And I would like to be an expert in my field.
Perfect, perfect. I think that was a satisfying answer. I hope you did not have any counter questions to that counter question. So any last tip, although you have given a lot of tips to the students, any last tip that you would want to, you know, give to the aspirants who are going to be writing the examination this year?
Yeah. So, the tip that I would give the aspirants is a very general one, that this path of competitive exams, especially in the government and public sector, it is littered with failures. And remember that all those who are successful were also failures at some point of time. It is just a universal fact. That's how it is. And you have to cover all the bases. That's the most important thing. For example, you cannot leave any current affairs. You cannot say that this is not important. It doesn't come in the exam much, so I will not cover it. You have to cover every base. You have to prepare for the interview as well. And you have to cover the phase two examination before phase one itself. And so these are the basic sanity checks, the basic hygiene factors that you have to tick. And after that, whatever happens will happen. And if you give a decent number of attempts with all these checks in mind, with completing all the bases, then you will definitely be successful in a large number of attempts, or even if you're lucky in your very first attempt itself.
Yes, I think very rightly said. If you are very honest with yourself and critical about your own performance, then I think you will get through. Perfect. Tuhin, thanks a lot for joining me and for sharing your thoughts as well as your experience. I think on one hand, you have shown everyone and yourself that, you know, failures, consistent failures does not mean that the streak is never going to end. And on the other hand, you've also shown that how you can use these failures for your own advantage and turn it into success. If not today, then tomorrow. That is something that has happened with you, but it has happened. These failures have given you the time to be successful in the end. Perfect. Thank you very much, Tuhin, for coming here and sharing your experience. I'm very certain that a lot of students are going to, going to benefit with your experience and whatever tips you've shared with us.
Thanks, Manoj. Thanks for having me.